Yeah, he caught the experience, I think, of everybody's week right on the money. I would just, I'd take issue with the line, like take issue with, I'd like to think that the longer this goes on, the more we suspect that even when this is over, that life is never coming back, not at least, not at the way we, it was at least. I hope he's wrong about that. And I'd use the counter argument. If you teach your kids the fear, hopefully you'll be able to teach them the ability to not fear again. And that's a real desire and hope for everybody right now. But it's so hard to even get into the sports pages, as you said now, and as you did last week, without plowing through some of the, and it has to be said, outstanding writing and really thought-provoking pieces that are across all of the newspapers today. I mean, I've spent 3 hours now reading the newspapers, which normally you, even on a full sports weekend, you mightn't spend 3 hours reading the newspapers, but there's just so much content there to engage you. And, you know, it's worth saying the newspaper industry is in a whole heap of bother as well as every other industry. And to their credit, there's a lot of public service stuff going on there as well, outside just the public service and the free to air broadcasters. So it's worth noting.
And I thought, thank you.